Hi guys, this is Dustin Thickpin, Mr. Too Blessed to be Stressed, and today I wanted to do a quick little review on the logo creator software by Laughing Bird. It's going to be a little quick review and also a little bit of a tutorial. I kind of want to walk you through just how you use it, because it's very easy. In comparison to some other software out there, there are some other ones out there. There's the Sothink Logo Maker. Sothink Logo Maker is actually pretty simple to use too, but I think that the logo creator is just a little bit more my alley. It's pretty much just grab a template and change it around, and you can have something really professional really fast. Or professional looking, should I say. Because I'm not a pro at making banners or anything, but it makes me look like I am, so I like it. So here we go. So this is the review for Logo Creator by Laughing Bird. Here's actually the program that I have up right now, and these are actually some templates that I've made or saved, some logos that I've used, and just to give you an idea, let's go ahead and go into one right now. Let's go into the logo templates that they give you, because they give you, there's several different, if you look in here, there's several different logo templates you can start with. And I mean, they are like some really, really professional looking logos. And by the way, guys, if you notice some of the ones I just showed you, I don't actually just use this for just logos. I use it to make ads, little ads for like banner ads and sidebar ads. It's very easy to custom make the banners to whatever size you want. I'm gonna show you that too. Let's just pick something really quick. This looks interesting. Okay, let's just pick this. You just click on a template, and it gives you the template. And what happens is, what you can actually click on the different aspects of the logo and change it. So like, I can change this word right here, hobby. You just click on hobby, and then you go to edit, and I can change it whatever I want. Since I don't know what this is a really kind of gruesome looking logo. But I'm gonna change it to bloody, because that's what it looks like. And see the splatter right here is actually just another layer. You can grab it and move it around. It's very easy to do. And so I can do whatever I want to with that. I can take the bloody right here. I can put it up here. I can take my little question mark over here. Put that up here. You know, it's really anything you want to do. You could take this text down here and grab it, and you could put it up under closer if you want. You can hit edit over here, and you can put whatever you want. I'm trying to think what to put it there. The goriest logo ever. And you implement it, change it. And then at that point you can actually just, you know, move it around. You can make it bigger if you want. You can go to, I think it's format. Let's see. Yeah, format. You can actually change the size of it. So you can make it really big. And on text scale, you can actually change how like far apart the words are. You can put them closer together. It's very, like I said, it's very simple to use. You can change the font. They've got a lot of cool different fonts in here and stuff. Oh, that's really hard to read. let me pick a different one. Evil Genius font. That's kind of cool looking. So you can grab, move it over. Let's make it a little bit smaller, because I made it really big. Space it out a little bit more. You can change the color of it. You can actually go to color. See right here? Everything's very simple, laid out. Let's make it black. Let's make it not black. Kind of makes it hard to read on this background. Okay, so this is really cool. You see how now the blood splatter, or whatever that is now on top of the wording. So you can actually just go to the top, and there's a thing that says send to back. It puts it behind it now. So I could do it like that, you know, and then I can go to image format and make the splatter really big, like that. I might get rid of the question mark. It's very easy to get rid of stuff, too. You just click on it, hit delete on your keyboard, and it goes away. The canvas, I was talking about different sizes. You know, you can make any size you want. I've actually used this program to make Facebook timeline photos. I've used it, like I said, to make ads, sidebar ads, and banner ads. I've used it to make blog banners. I've used it for just different graphics for my websites. It's been very, very helpful and very easy to use. It's not really expensive either. It's pretty affordable. It's pretty cheap, actually. So that's that. Let me go ahead and show you how you can change the size. So if you click on the canvas, like the background, you can click that and hit Format Canvas. You can choose to make it whatever size you want. So you could change the width right here. You could change the height. But if you know the exact dimensions that you want it, you can just type it in. Like I can type in 800 by 600. And it's exactly that size. So it's very easy just to type in whatever dimensions you want. And of course, you can move the stuff around within there if you want. Like I said, you know, make it bigger, whatever you want to do. So that's very easy to do. And actually, just to show you an example, this background that I made for my wife for our anniversary, I was just kind of goofing off the morning of our anniversary, and I found out the dimensions of, you know, my background, my resolution on my computer, and actually went and, you know, just kind of threw some different graphics on here, and, you know, wrote a little, put some different fonts and wrote some cool stuff on here. And, you know, so that was really, you know, that was a big hit with her. another few examples. On my Facebook page, Mr. Too Blessed to Be Stressed. If you can't see it, it's facebook.com/ Mr. Too Blessed to Be Stressed. I actually made this timeline photo with Logo Creator. And all I did was just kind of import some pictures and put them on top of other pictures. And then just, you know, had some fonts, cool fonts at the bottom, and just put Mr. Too Blessed to Be Stressed. And this picture also is actually done with Logo Creator. It's just a picture of my daughter holding up a white sign, and I just wrote on top of it with Logo Creator. We just, you know, I just chose some font that I liked, and it came out really well. So that is one thing. Also, I've done my banner up here on top of my blog. I've made this entirely with Logo Creator. And actually, just about everything in this banner, except for my picture, is all like stuff that Logo Creator comes with. Of course, the fonts and stuff are theirs, but also the pictures, the money, the thumbs up popping out. That's all really easy to do in Logo Creator. And actually, show you that, you guys, that in a second. Same thing with here. Like, so that's the same picture off of Facebook. Actually, workwithmydad.com. I did that with Logo Creator. If you go to the website, I did something very similar. I just wrote something different on it right there. But yeah, there's a lot of cool stuff you can do with it. So that's just a couple examples. And let me actually go into it and show you some stuff that I've done with it. Let's see. Let's go to the top and go to New Template. Don't save changes. And the cool thing is you can save your own templates. Like, these are really cool ones, the one they have, but I've made my own. Just because I've had ones for Facebook and stuff that I kind of change around from my wall and stuff, my timeline. And if you look, I can kind of show you real quick how I made the one for my timeline I just showed you. I have this one main picture that I took at an Empower Network event in Denver, Colorado. It's really cool. It's like at the end of the event, they have like sparks going everywhere and these big giant Empower Network balloon balls jumping around, you know. And then I took those and I took some other pictures I had at Aaron Rashkin's Barbecue with David Sharp and his soon-to-be wife. And with Chris Record and with Vic Strauss, I had some cool pictures. So I just threw them on top. And you can see, like, I just literally threw them. Like, you can actually grab the pictures and you can move them over and see. And actually just covered up the screens that were in here. And this is my font that I used. I forget what font it is. Sketch Rock Will Bold. It just looked really cool with Mr. Too Blessed to Be Stressed on it, so that's what I did. So this logo probably took me a matter of maybe 10-15 minutes to make, and if you look at the canvas size, it'll tell you what it is. And what I did was I just found out the dimensions of a Facebook timeline photo, and you can find that on Google like very easy. So I just found out that it was 851 by 315, and I just put that as my canvas size, and that's how I was able to put it to the exact right dimensions. And I left a little space over here on the bottom left so I could put a little picture of my daughter right here. So it all turned out very nice, and it's really easy to do. And I highly suggest you guys get Logo Creator. It's a really cool tool. One thing I don't like about it is it might be just be my computer's a little bit slow, but like if you notice, I kind of clicked over. There's a little bit of delay when you start to like import lots of pictures. So you can go to File at the top. You can go to Import PNG or JPEG. These are just picture files. But once you start to put a lot of them together in here, it starts to slow down a little bit. So I think it's just because they're very high quality pictures that I'm using. Like, I didn't reduce the quality at all. I just shrunk them down. I told you I did this very fast. But if you look at this picture, as I make it bigger, you can tell like the quality is very high. And I did not reduce the resolution or anything on them. All these pictures, me with Dave Sharp at Aaron Rashkin's house, and these pictures, me with Chris Record, they're very high resolution. You can see there's no degradation in quality as I make it bigger. So that was, I was just trying to save time on my part. But yeah, I'm sure if you reduce the quality that they would actually move around a little bit faster. But yeah, you can see there's a little bit of delay. I'm actually trying to drag it over right now. So, but that's my main gripe with it. If you could just be a little patient, though, it's actually one of the easiest software creation programs I've ever used. And I've used programs like, you know, PaintShop Pro and GIMP. And you could do a lot with those, but there's just so many options. It's almost a little overwhelming. And this is a little bit more straightforward. Just real quick before I end this, let me go ahead and show you something really quick. Okay, obviously we have all these cool logos that it comes with, right? And, oh yeah, too, I don't know if you guys saw this. Just a couple different little banner ads and stuff that I've made. So this is very easy, you know, I have my own little thing off of Empower Network. I took a few pictures of some checks, and I'll link back to a capture page that has these exact same pictures on them. So, you know, this is very simple to make. This probably took me like 5 minutes or probably like 3 minutes. And some other stuff I've made too, very easy. Some banner ads. If you look at this one, you can see it. I just put some words, change some fonts, add some money. And this money actually is in there already. Let me show you real quick. Let's just start with a new template. Let's start with blank slate, because you don't have to use the you know, cool stuff that they have. You can make your own. So you can go to the top up here, and they have all these different shapes and stuff. And this is actually how I did some of my Empower letters on my logo on my website here. The E and the N, I took them off of this little part right here. So I got a cool stuff. You got little, like, what do you call them? Like mascots and characters you can add. You actually have textures you could use, which I think is really cool. I like the texture packs. This all comes included with it. This is nothing, I didn't pay extra for any of this stuff. It's all included with the logo creator software. So, you know, if you want like a nice, you know, textured wooden background, you can just click this. All you do is take it and you drag it and you let go. That's how simple that is. You're going to have a nice wooden background. If you see these grid lines on here too, you can actually, this is just to show you where the grid is on the picture, but these will disappear when you save the picture. Well, let's just make something really quick just so I can show you guys how easy and how fast this is. So yeah, guys, and you can choose, let's see, like, let's just choose some weird character for fun. Let's grab this little dude. See, he's pretty high quality. He's already pretty big, and you can use him any way you want. So let's grab him, and then let's scale him down a little bit. And I don't really know what I'm gonna do with him. I'm just gonna make something really quick here. Let's put him catching money. That'll be pretty funny, right? Let's drop a pile of money on his head. And look, see, he's ready for it. He's waiting for it. Arms wide open. See, this is cool too. I like this. This is actually what I want to use in my ad. It's like falling money, but you can scale it, and you can send it to the back. Oop, I sent it too far back. Let's send the background to the back. There we go. So you have this little falling money effect, and I can put it behind the big pile of money, so it kind of looks like it's coming undone as it's going down, you know. And this is really cool too. Check this out. Let's take this little guy. Make his eyes really big, you know, because he's waiting for the money to come down. So put little eyeballs on there, scale them down a little bit. Let's see. And yeah, so we put the money there. I'm gonna move it up a little bit. He's waiting to catch the money, and we can just put let's put some text in here. This is really easy to put text. You can just type it at the top. And you can hear my Facebook messages going crazy. So here we go. So let's pretend this like it's like an ad or a logo for some sort of money or business opportunity, or, you know, something to do with making money. So let's put literally catch free money from the sky. Every day, all day. Yeah, we'll leave it at that. Yeah, this is just, you know, goofing around, guys. So you hit add to canvas, and then it puts it down here, and now you can space out your letters. Let's see, I'm not gonna make it too big. I just wanted to show you how easy this is, guys, because it's really easy and fast. You can change your spacing, character spacing. That's a little bit too spaced out. And I can change the font. I think I'm gonna choose something a little bit crazier. That's cool. Let's edit this. So yeah, let's see. Implement. I'm gonna break that text up a little bit, make it a little bit easier to read. Let's just choose a couple different little fonts here too. Make it kind of crazy looking. Space it out. Drag it down here. Let's see. All right. So make that bigger. Literally catch money from the sky every day, all day, and just for fun, let's put one more little graphic on here. Yeah, I could spend more time on this. It's actually a lot of fun using this thing. So we're just going to do this real quick. I'm just going to throw a little bubble in there, a little text bubble in there. And this little dude's going to be saying something really crazy. I don't know exactly what, but, you know, let's just make him say, like, awesome or something. So you just type awesome, add text to canvas, drag it in there. The little bubble, make it a little bit smaller, and we're done. So, yep, and that's all you do. So it's kind of cool, you know. I like it a lot. It makes creating logos and ads and Facebook stuff, like, it makes it fun, and it also makes it very easy. And when you get done, all you do is go to file at the top, and then you just go to save as PNG or JPEG, whichever picture file or picture format you want. You can also save as a transparent PNG, which means that, you know, if you're having like a white background or a colored background on your website, you know, it'll be transparent, so it'll come through. So obviously I have a background, so it won't be transparent. But it's very easy to do. You just save it, you know, as whatever. And it's there. But yeah, it's really that easy, and I love it, guys. It's really cool piece of software. If you want to check it out, there's a link below this YouTube video, and you can click there and you can grab it. I think right now it's actually a pretty good deal. It's like $30 or something like that. So pick it up today. Just go click below and buy it and use it and love it. That's it for today, guys. This is Dustin Thigpen, Mr. Too Blessed to Be Stressed, that's it. Later, guys.